So shaitan and nafs are both like real brothers. They both work together. Their schemes are same. They both want to deviate us. They both want to attract us and pull us towards the back. And they are both helping one another. Allah Pak has made this system such that Allah Pak has made this dunya open, open-minded. Keep your minds open. That's the good, that's the bad. Take whatever you want. Choose for yourself. If you choose good, you will be rewarded. If you choose bad, you will be punished. So it's up to you. And for this, when you want to test a person, you have to put both things in front of him and then see whether he succeeds or whether he fails. So for that reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put both sides into the human nature. Now some humans are attracted towards lammatul malak and inspiration and from ilham, from the angel. And when he says, do this, come on, get up, go for your Fajr Salat, go to the masjid, do this good deed, do zikr of Allah, read some Quran, and do some zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, do this good thing, help that old person, and help him cross the road, and do khidmat of your mother told you to get medicine, go get it from the chemist, help her, take her to the hospital, you know, do khidmat of your parents. So these are good things, good things for them. Angels actually talk to us, he tells us to do that good thing. He helps us. So this is from the good side where the angel is helping us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting into our hearts and minds the good things that we need to do. Now we need to use our brains and understand the good things which we have been ordered and follow in that footstep. From the bad side, the nafs, it will never tell you to do anything more. Nafs is evil and it likes evil and it will only attract you towards evil. It doesn't like good. It doesn't like getting up for Fajr Salah. Nafs will put you down and put you inside your beddings and say, go to sleep. It's a cold, wintry, freezy morning. Why are you going to get up and do wudu with cold water and walk yourself to the masjid? Go back to sleep. You can pray your Fajr 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock when you get up. Now, nafs won't let you get up for Fajr Salah. Nafs won't let you come for Zuhar, for Maghrib, for Isha, for Asr. Nafs will say, just sit here, don't go. And it will attract you towards evil. Nafs will take you towards bad deeds, sinning, towards zina, fornication, adultery, or sharab noshi, drugs. Nafs likes these things. Because shaitan likes it, nafs also likes it, so it's pulling you towards it. You have to understand, when some bad thought comes in your mind, it's from shaitan and it's from nafs. They are both working together and they are both trying to deviate you, mislead you, misguide you, lead you astray, take you far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to understand that and develop this understanding. This is the reality of the nafs. And every human being has nafs with him. Everyone has this nafs. And what we need to do is now understand how to control that nafs.